Hello! Today I'm going to try to explain a little bit more about adding some interesting strumming into plain note-by-note playing. As an example, we're going to use the song Sugar Hill, which I have tabbed out in my blog. You see the link here on this site. I have it tabbed in the key of C in Ionian mode, but that's okay. You can still play it in D in Ionian mode just the same way, using the same tab numbers. You'd be tuning your bass string to D, your middle string to A, and your melody strings to A as well. So that puts the melody based on the third fret, like that. So, first of all, let's go over the strums that we were looking at before on a previous video. Some people strum out as their main strum direction. I tend to strum in. And it doesn't really matter, whichever you like better. But when I talk about going back and forth, I'm going to refer to it as, instead of in and out or out and in, I'll refer to it as up, down, up, down, up. And that way, it doesn't matter whether you're an innie or an outie, you'll still understand what I mean. When I say down, it's your main stroke. Like if you're an out stroker, you would go down. And if I say down, up, down, it would be. And if you're an in strummer, it would be down. And down, up, down would be. So remember, this song, Sugar Hill, if you play it as simply as possible, as a new beginner, you would be going something like this in the beginning of the song. And that would be, if you want to get your eye knocked out, if you want to get your thrill. So, that would be a pretty basic way to play it. I'm going to try strumming out here with just plain strums out. If you want to get your eye knocked out, now, that's very good, but it doesn't have a lot of rhythmic interest. So, we would like to add, instead of just, we're going to add some, and remember the bump ditty? The bump ditty rhythm goes, it goes, bump ditty, bump ditty. Otherwise known as down, down, up, down, down, up. That adds a lot of interest. So taking that simple part of that tune, and instead of just going out on every note or just going in on every note, you're going to add some out-in or in-out, depending on which direction you prefer to strum in. So instead of going, I'm going to add some in strums too here, and it'll be like adding a little bump ditty here and there. Notice I don't do that on every note, because that would be sort of annoying after a while. It would be like somebody saying, you know, after everything they say. So, let's see. That's a way to add some interest here. So let's just do that one more time. Instead of just the plain notes, we're going to have a bump ditty once in a while, okay? Here it comes. Let's do that again. So you can add some bump ditties in there and it makes it sound a lot better. There's also other things to add some interest here, and one of them is a hammer-on. We're going to just show that right now. I don't know how much time I have left in this video, but we'll try to do something. Here is how the song goes. It goes, if you want to get your eye knocked out, if you want to get your fill, and the fill is on this first fret. But you could play that straight like this and get to the first fret and just do your straight note there. But notice that when I get there, I go bum diddy bum diddy. However, here's a hammer-on. You first strum open, and then you put your noter on there. Now you really have to do a hammer-on onto an open string if you're playing noter style, because you have to take it off in order to put it on. So once you take it off, you've got an open string. So you'll find a lot of hammer-ons on the first fret and fewer when you're on the other frets, just because of that fact. So here, we'll add that instead of going. We're going to go like this. See? I'll try to do that strumming out too. Let's just do that again. See that hammer-on? Now you have to make sure both of those sounds happen. Don't hammer on immediately, because you're just going to get the one note. So you go open and hammer it on. Now we're going to go more and learning some slides on this tune in the next video, because I think I'm running out of time here. So let's just go through it one more time quickly. So next time we'll go further in this song and learn some other techniques. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoyed that.